go wild and go ahead and
see how it goes. Hearst, they think they got us. Do they got us? Pulitzer Hearst, they think they got us. Do they? Oh, no, they think we're nothing.
Hello, Pulitzer. Whenever you're ready.
You're probably asking, why did I get blue? Why doesn't my daughter work for me? Good question. I offered Catherine a life of wealth and leisure. Instead, she chose to pursue a career. And she was showing real promise until this recent lapse. But you're dumb about that now, aren't you, sweetheart? Don't trouble the boy with your problems, dearest. Mr. Kelly has a plate full of his own. Would you say so, Mr. Snyder?
Do they got us?
How? Sing for me.
Mumsy on those wings, had it for fair. We would do it just by saying so.
You're easy. You're good. You're so easy.
We can fix things.
Less? Crutchy. Sorry. Wrong cat. Go ahead and start talking.
This year, his name is Jack Kelly. He once escaped jail off of Teddy Roosevelt's carriage, made all the papers. It's not with Jack is the chance of a lifetime. You learn from him, you learn from the best. Wouldn't it strike me more effective if someone in charge knew about it? Can I stand?
Yeah, please.
How are you? I'm okay. Guess I wasn't much help yesterday. Snyder soaked me real good with my crutch.
Oh yeah, Jack. This is Crutchy, by the way.
Oh, yes. These here guards, they did true. They say jump, boy, you jump.
Right. Or screw.
But the food ain't so badly so far. Cause so far they ain't brung us no food. Ha ha. I miss the rooftop.
Thank you.
Pleasure.
You bump into Les. Tell Les to come out here. All right, as soon as you can, I need you to shake loose and get up here and run sound effects.
70, ready. I've got no use for moonlight or sappy poetry. Love at first sight's for suckers, at least it used to be. The girls are nice, once or twice, till I find someone new. I never planned on no one like you. I've got no use.
Go ahead, Les.
Yeah, talk to the back of the house. Thank you.
Yeah.
The girls are nice
until he says,
once or twice, till I find someone new. I never planned on no one like you. I've got no use for moonlight or sappy poetry. Love at first sight's for suckers, at least they used to be.
There's a play going. Quiet down. Chris, can you play your keyboard, please?
Mr. Phillips, I know this isn't
an interview,
but we are missing Ray and Bobby. They did not show up to their 6 o'clock call. And we've tried calling and texting. They're not answering.
I don't have their numbers.
I'm just worried.
I understand.
So, I'm going to go get changed and go to notes, but...
I'll see what I can do about tracking them down.
Are we done with mic checks? We're done with this.
We are done. You can open house.
Great. We're doing it. Thank you.
You're welcome.
That's where mine went back.
Everything went fine. Nobody got hurt.
Oh.
Or at least two. Understand what it was.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
I went in there and they were using the computer and they were playing music in there, having a party. I had to go in there and be like, all right, guys, I got to turn on the lights. So I had to poop their party for about like 5 seconds. Yeah, see, I went up there and clicked the space bar and paused it and everybody got mad.
No, we don't
want
to.
Thank you.
You see the video?
No, the video didn't come through.
They'll walk in there and be like, alright guys, sorry to crash, but hey. I'm looking forward to the band room with that thing. Do I game this pill is holding the guitar?
From then on, we started like,
got two current videos and two playbacks. Yes. Because I would do a home after this, and I'd be like having to clean the house up afterwards. Yeah, I got a little assistant to like direct the house. So I got to pick up after her.
Thank you. had my ribs last night.
I had steak.
We went to Piggy and Harry's last night. Yeah. They had ribs.
I just went home. My dad had steak in the microwave and potato red and moon stools. And here you go. Yeah. I was like, thanks.
Sounds good.
Yeah. It's best that's straight off the grill.
What kind of car was that that you had?
The car that was a Volvo.
That was a Volvo?
Yeah.
It's pretty tough, like a convertible.
They got it at a buy here pay like 1,000 pounds.
Really?
Yeah. We only had one problem with it. We just had to replace a little piece in the car that was made for engine rev up, but we got it to it. That headlight, that's about it.
Man, I'm not a convertible guy, but that was a convertible.
Yeah, that's what my dad said. That's a nice car. It's got Bluetooth in it. It's tuned since 2009. Pretty good.
Yeah, that was high end at that time.
Oh, yeah, that was pretty high end. I bet you that cost more than. Oh,
now it's standard.
Yeah. Standard in there. It's like, oh, man. Cool.
Maximum security is number one. Affordable and taxes. but it's good. And it is a sloppy truck.
It looks like it's just raining there, wasn't it?
Yeah, oh, it was pouring down about a half hour ago.
I saw one part, I saw where it's pouring and I was relaxed.
I think Bobby will win.
Thank you.
Bob didn't get his hand.
Yep.
5 weeks to raise up the grades, and my teacher just dropped on me. We went from third quarter to fourth quarter. Came back from fourth quarter, all just like fell down. It's because I'm Mr. Changer. I missed two videos and one quiz, so that kind of popped it down a bit. Then I pulled that one up to the second grade, but then she graded a test from the third quarter and bumped my down grade down more. And then this one on the left side is missing a couple days, so I gotta make a change.
I'll be done
with testing. Yeah. I gotta write an essay about something that's
happening to
you.
Which is probably
good.
Yeah,
I was gonna tell you that.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's a cross. This is like 6. Look at the side down. I'd rather put it in the cup and drink it out. Drink it, drink it.
Thank you. Thank you.
$1,500. So if you would, just please keep going together. If you would, please keep giving, and thank you so much. The show's going to begin shortly.
My boys are good. Huh?
I
thank you. Thank you.
Gentlemen, it'll be the exact opposite. You go out these doors, you go, you get to the hall, you take a right, and then it'll be on your left. Flash photography. Please refrain from flash photography during this performance. We've had an excellent professional photographer, Byron Collins. I'm sure many of you know him. He photographs everything around Pensacola High School. He has been taking pictures throughout this entire process, and he's done an excellent job. And those are available if you Google Byron Collins in folio. Those are all available online for you to get. So please refrain from doing that. Also, cell phones, please turn those off during the performance. They're distracting to the actors on stage and to you trying to watch the show. So please turn those off. Aisleways, please keep those clear during the performance. We have actors that go up and down the aisleways several times throughout the show, and just try to keep those clear as much as possible. And finally, when you get the chance, please take a look at your program. There's a little information sheet about the Hendersonville High School Senior Play Tradition Maker Award. This is an annual award given to someone who has really supported the school throughout senior play and throughout the time. And this year's award winner is Pat Shepard. Award during intermission last night, so please take a moment and check out all that stuff on your program. And lastly, thank you all for being here. It's been a roller coaster ride throughout for all of us, and we just all appreciate so much that you're taking time out of your Saturday night to come watch us perform this play. We hope you have as much fun watching it as we've had making it and performing it. And so with that being said, let's seize the day. And for one final time, the class of 2019 presents Newsies. Thank you.
Sun and stars?
You're seeing stars, all right.
Those streets suck the life right out of all of them. Bribe jobs and getting stomped on by bosses. When they finally broke them, they kicked them out to the curb like yesterday's paper. We ain't doing that to me.
But everyone wants to come here.
New York is only good for those who can afford the big doors and lock it out. But Crunchy, I tell you, there's another way. You can have your small life in a big city. I'll take my big life in a small town. They say folks is dying to get there. Me, I'm dying to get away to a little town out west that's spanking new. And while I ain't
never been there. I can see it clear as day. If you were, I bet you could see it too. Close your eyes, come with me, where it's clean and green and pretty. And they went and made a city out of clay. Why, the moment that you get there, there's a wall right up and say, welcome home, son, welcome home to Santa Fe. Swapping tails around the fire, except for Sundays when we lie around all day. Soon your friends are more like family, and they're begging you to stay. Ain't that neat? Living sweet in Santa Fe.
You got folks there?
Ain't got no folks, no.
I got folks. Got friends.
How's about you come with me? No one gives about a bum leg in Santa Fe. You just hop in Palomino and ride in style.
Feature me, riding in style.
But a few months of fresh air, you'll be able to toss that crutch for good.
Thank you.
like, not again.
3 weeks of the same story. They're killing us with that smooth.
Make my stuff a star.
Hey! Hey! Dear me, what's that unpleasant aroma I smell? I fear the sewers may have backed up during the night.
Or it could be.
The Ramsey Brothers.
They asked him. Word on the streets, you and your brother got paid to beat up them striking trolley workers.
So, he's down his way.
But busting the heads of defenseless workers? Come on!
Hey, I take care of the guy who takes care of me.
And your father, one of the strikers.
Yes, he did take care of me.
Man, want some of that too?
Whoa! Hey,
that's not nice, Boris.
Five one back, some
something. Yeah!
What a fortunate day. You might find yourself in a fun game of your own. How would you like us picking up? Maybe we should find out.
Heads for losers! Line up!
Wait till I get my hands on you.
We're gonna have to catch you first. Good morning, Weasel.
The name's Wiseau.
Is that what I said? I'll take it. We'll be on my way.
100 pages for the wise guy. Next.
How's it going, Weasel?
At least call me Mister.
I call you sweetheart if you spot me, can you take?
Drop the cash and move along.
Whatever happened to romance?
Good morning, Mr. Wiseau.
Good morning, Crutchy. Would you have a look at this? A new kid.
I'm new too. The more kid rubs right off.
I'll take 20 new things, please. Let's see the dime. I'll pay you when I sell. 20, kid. Cash up front. But whatever I don't sell, you'll buy back, right? Certainly. And every time you lose a tooth, I'll put a penny on your pillow. This kid's a riot. Cash up front. Kablow! Come on, Albert. Let's see your money.
You know, you have a very interesting face. Ever think of getting into the picture?
You think I could?
Sure, buy a ticket. They let anyone in.
Sorry, excuse me. I paid for 20, but you gave me 19.
You see how nice I was to this new kid? And what do I get for my civility? Ungrounded accuracy.
This one's what I paid for.
He said B.
Who could write? Gave me 19. Sir, it's the honest mistake on the count of Oscar. Can't count to 20 with shoes.
Here, now take your pipe.
Give him a 50 more pages.
I don't want more pages.
What kind of news you don't want more pages?
I'm not Jerry Case. I don't even know you.
His name's Jack.
Yeah.
This here is your famous Jack Kelly. He once escaped jail off of Teddy Roosevelt's carriage. Made all the papers.
Hey, how are you?
I'm
10. Minimum class, you're 7. Younger sells more papers. We're going to be partners.
You said we want a partner.
Selling with Jack is the chance of a lifetime. You learn from him, you learn from the best.
Well, he's the best, then what's he need with me?
You have a little brother. I don't. That pussy is going to sell 1,000 papers a week. What's that? Minimum. David, nice to meet you. Our 2 bits come off the top and we split everything 70-30.
Hey, 50-50, you were trying to pull a fast one, okay?
60-40, that's my final offer.
Deal.
That's disgusting.
The price of doing business. News, he's hitting the streets. The headline stinks, and this kid ain't getting any younger.
Whoever said war is hell wasn't trying to sell a newspaper.
You can use
What have we got today?
Trolley
train. That's not exciting. It's epic.
It's boring. Folks want to know, is the trolley coming or ain't it? No one cares why. If anybody strikes a doubt to be settled, Governor Roosevelt just put his support behind the workers.
That man is a socialist.
Teddy Roosevelt is no socialist. He's an American hero.
The man wants to outlaw football for being too violent. Football? Violent? You're right. He's no socialist. He's a commie.
Mr. Pulitzer, please. You must try and sit still.
Please. You are making Nunzio nervous. And when Nunzio's nervous, I don't look pretty.
You never liked Roosevelt. He wrote editorials day after day when he ran for governor. And guess what? He got elected.
How can I influence voters if they're not reading my opinion?
Big photos attract
readers. Do you know what big photos cost?
Both about flashy photos and headlines. How are you expected to sell more papers?
There's an answer right before your eyes. You're not thinking this through. Nunzio knows when he's cutting my hair. Trim a bit here and then trim a bit there. Just a modest adjustment can flatten the bottom line. Shaving is tricky, the razor should float. It's the simple solutions that bolster the bottom line.
But how is that
supposed
to help us sell more papers?
We don't sell papers, Billy. Newsies sell papers.
I've got it. Right now, we charge the newsies 50 cents per 100 papers.
Yes?
But if we raise the price to, say, 60 cents per 100...
Now you're getting somewhere.
A mere tenth of a penny per paper.
Every single newsie would have to sell 25 more papers, just to earn the same amount as always.
My thought exactly. It's genius. Nonsense. I'm giving them a real life lesson in economics. I could not give them a better education to better my own.
Give me a week and I'll train them. Like an army that's marching to war.
Bad enough for death.
How'd you get home with us for dinner?
mostly happy to have you.
Mom's a great cook.
Thanks for the invite, but I just remembered I should meet with the fella, and he should be around here somewhere.
Is that the guy here?
Rochelle! You, Officer Grimm! You look stuck!
Thank you.
Hey, baby, I was just talking to you. Now this is sport. This life's too short to waste it on you.
First sucker, at least.
what'd you do with the one you had?
Changed her for a box of cigars.
They were Coronas. We have a father too.
Oh, a mother and a father.
And we have a hoy floor. So how are you doing today?
Ask me if they broke a hammer.
Here comes that.
Newsy price, 60 cents per 100.
What you say? Is that news?
It is to me.
They jack up the price of paves, 10 cents per 100.
I get 2 days on a dime.
I'll be sleeping on the streets.
You already sleep on the street.
In a worse neighborhood.
What are you all standing around for?
Get a load of this, Jack.
My bolts don't make enough already.
Heads for the newsies. Relax, it's gotta be a catch.
Line up.
No, you really got the fellas going. I'll take my employee to be on the way.
100 will cost you 60.
Well, I'm paying those 60.
Well, then make way for someone who whipped.
You bet. Me and the fellas will just take Ike to the German.
Yeah!
I'm saving the farmers. They up their prices too.
Then we'll take our business to the sun.
It's the same all around town. New day, new price.
Why the jackpot?
For them kind of answers, you gotta ask a little further at the food chain. So are you buying or are you moving on?
Come here, fellas.
They can't just do that, can they?
Why not? It's their place.
It's their world.
And we got rights.
Yeah, we got the right to starve. Come on, fellas, let's just grab our pates and hit the streets while we still can.
Prices?
We got a choice.
Hold on, no one's paying, no do nothing.
Hey, you got an idea?
Keep your shirt on. Let me think this through.
What's your angle?
Yeah. Hey, stop crowding him. All right? Let him think it through.
Alright, here's the deal. We don't sell papers, no one sells papers. No one goes to that window until the prices are back where they need to be.
You mean like a strike?
You're a neighbor on a strike.
Hold on, I didn't say anything about
strike. You shut down this place like the workers shut down the trolley.
The cops will bust our heads. Half the workers is laid up with broke bones.
Those cops don't care about a bunch of kids, right, David?
Leave me out of this. I'm just here trying to feed my family.
And the rest of us is on playtime? Just because we make pennies don't give them the right to rub our noses in it.
It doesn't matter. You can't strike. You're not a union.
What if I said it?
Well, there's a lot of things you gotta have in order to be a union. Like, membership.
Who do you call these guys?
And officers.
I nominate Jack as president.
Yeah!
I'm touched.
How about a statement of purpose?
I must be left in my defense.
What's the statement of purpose?
A reason for forming the union.
What reason is the trouble?
Wages? Work hours? Safety on the job?
Yeah, who told you that? Better if your dad had a union, you wouldn't be out here selling papers, right, David?
Yeah.
Okay, so our union is hereby formed to watch each other's backs. Union, we stand. Somebody write that down. I like that.
Hey, I got a pencil.
Meet our Secretary of State now.
Want to strike, the membership's got to vote.
Got it. What do you say, fellas? Roll over and let Pulitzer pick our pockets or do a strike? You heard the voice of the membership. Losers of Lower Manhattan now officially on strike. What's next?
Oh, would this strike be more effective than have someone in charge go around it? It'd be a pleasure to tell people myself.
Yep. Who tells the list? David?
I don't know. I guess you do, Mr. President.
That's right. We do. What do we tell them?
The newspaper owners need to respect your rights as employees.
Pulitzer hurts. Much respect for the rights of the working kids in the city.
Yeah, they can't change the rules when they feel like it.
That's right. We do the work, so we get a say.
Yeah. We've got a union.
Yeah!
Pulitzer hurts. They think they got us. Do they got us?
No!
They need to understand that we're not enslaved to them. We're free agents.
They think we're nothing. Are we nothing?
No!
We're a union now. And we mean business.
What we gotta do until we break the will of mine.
Thank you. Ride it good. Ride it good or it's back to wheezing your way through the flower show. No pressure. Let's go. Newsies stop the world. Little hyperbole never hurt anyone. With all eyes fixed on the trolley strike, there's another battle brewing in the city. And if I could just write about it. Come on, Catherine, those boys are counting on you. Oh, you poor boys. Write what you know, so they say. All I know is I don't know what to write. Write, read, or write it. This is it, lady, don't screw it up. This is not the little God. Will I read you? Poor little kids. Sourpusses. It's a cinch. It can practically write itself on what some brain does. Because I'm being a fidget, I have no clue what I'm doing. Am I insane? This is what I've been waiting for. Will that scream? It's an angry editor. It's a girl. It's a girl. How the hell? Is that even legal? Look, let's go and get her. Not only that, this is a story about kind of 3,000 of children exploited, invisible. Speak up, take a stand.
Well, we have to be right back. So, yeah, as soon as we get the nod from name's Mishra Midtown.
Hey, Oscar! Looks like we got some bum information about a strike coming here today. Not that I'm complaining. My scoreless snobs can use a damn rest.
Are we doing the right thing?
Sure we are.
Maybe we just put this off for a couple of days.
Yeah. No, we can't. Say something. Tell them that if we back down now, they will never listen to us again.
We can't back down. No matter who does or doesn't show, now's the time we take a stand.
How about we just don't show up for work? That will send a message.
Yes.
They'll just replace us. They need to see us stand our ground. Come on, David, tell them.
Let us see.
line. Lucy's crushed as bulls attack. Crunchy's calling me dumb crips just too damn slow. Guys are fighting, bleeding, falling. Thanks to good old Captain Jack. Captain Jack just wants to close his eyes and go! Let me go far away. Somewhere they won't never find me. And tomorrow won't remind me of today. When the city's finally asleep and the moon looks old and gray, I get on the train that's bound for Santa Fe. And I'm done, and I'm done. No more running, no more lying. No more fat old men denying me my pain. Just the moon so big and yellow, it turns night right into day.
I thought which favorite
Yeah, that's the biggest thing that I like. The biggest thing is back there.
Thank you.
Thank you.
didn't give you nothing. You think water is nothing?
Just ask a fish to death.
Why do old people talk?
It's my turn. Hey! Dorothy walks with the chain to twirl in her much help yesterday. Snyder soaked me real good with my crutch. Oh yeah, Jack. This is Reggie, by the way. These here gods, they is rude. They say jump or you jump, you're screwed. But the food ain't so badly so far. So far they ain't brung us no food.
Crying out loud. Where's the fella gotta go to get away from you people?
There's no escaping us, pal. We're inevitable.
So what's the story?
Lie down with your hands together.
What's the hold up? I need to let my girl know we've got a date.
Your girl?
You heard me. I've been swatting away skirts all morning. Babe is one intoxicate potion. And this here girl, Sally, she's a plum.
Where it is you brought the drinks to?
You look quite tell. Hey, Jack, what's this supposed to be?
It's Santa Fe.
I've got to tell you, Jack, this whole go west young man routine is getting tired. And then he died.
Ain't reporters supposed to be non-partisan?
Ask for a reporter. Pulitzer shut down every news desk in town. Hey, can we table the flower and get down to business? Will Medalos have a theater?
It's what I've been trying to tell you. We want to hold a rally where every newsie gets a say and a vote. And we hold it after working hours so no one loses a day's pay.
What? Smart enough to get you committed to a pageant room.
Really? The guy who paints places he's never seen before is calling us crazy?
You want to see a place I've seen? Look at this. Thanks to my big mouth, Newsy Square, filled to overflowing with family. Kids hurt, others arrested.
I'm not. No one died.
Is that what you're aiming for? Call me a coward. Call me a quitter. Ain't no way I'm putting those kids back in danger.
We are doing something that has never been done before. How could that not be dangerous?
Specs brought me a note from Crunchy as a reference. I tried to see him climb the fire escape, but they busted him up so bad he couldn't even get to the window. What if he don't make it? Is that something you're willing to shoulder for a tenth a penny of pay?
It's not about pennies. You said it yourself. My family wouldn't be in the situation we're in if my father had a union. This is a fight we have to win.
I wanted a sermon on show up at church.
Tell me how quitting does Crunchy any good. Exactly. So here's how it goes. Once we win, and we will be winning, make no mistake.
We'll be what?
We're already winning.
What?
And we'll tell them straight out, they let Crunchy go, but they keep getting money.
Dave, what the hell did they bust up? You're praying for something as I recall, Dave. We all got our asses kicked. They won.
Won the battle. Can you think about it? We got them surrounded.
He's a rattlesnake.
You're right. And you know why he sticks us the rattle?
No, why?
Cause he's scared. Go and look it up. The poor guy's head is spinning. Why would he send for the goons? Didn't tie around me dozens of goons plus the cops.
And you know you may be right.
Thank you, God.
If he wasn't afraid.
Exactly.
He know we're winning.
Get those kids to see what's certainly victory. And watch what happens.
Snyder. Which one is it? Yes, that one there. Jack Hill.
And how do you know this boy?
He was first sentenced to my refuge for loitering in vagrancy, but his total disregard of authority has made him a frequent visitor.
You called him a thief and escaped convict.
Yes. After his release, I caught him myself red-handed trafficking stolen food and clothing. He was sentenced to 6 months, but the willful ruffian escaped.
So you'd be doing the city a service, removing this criminal from our streets.
Well, if that's the case, we'll take him in quietly and—
What good would quiet do me? I want a public example, maybe.
Mr. Pulitzer, the boy, Jack Kelly, is here.
Here? Asking, you shall be received. Mr. Snyder, if you please, sit.
Mr. Jack Kelly.
Good afternoon, gents.
And which Jack Kelly is this? The charismatic union organizer or the petty thief and escaped convict?
Which one gives us more confidence?
Impudence is in poor taste when crawling for mercy.
Crawling? That's a laugh. I stopped by on an invite. Seems a few hundred of your employees are rallying to discuss recent disagreements. I thought it only fair for you to state your case straight to the fellas. What do you say, Joe, when I say you spot on the bill?
You are as shameless and disrespectful a creature as I was known. Do you know what I was doing when I was your age, boy? I was fighting in a war!
Yeah? How'd that work out?
It taught me a lesson that shaped my life. You don't win a war on the battlefield. It's the headline that crowns the victory.
And I'll keep that in mind when New York wakes up the front page photos of our rally.
Rally till the cows come home. Not a paper in town will publish a word. And if it's not in the papers, it never happens.
You may run the city. There are some of us who can't be bullied. Even some reporters.
Such as that young reporter who made you yesterday's news. Talented girl. And beautiful as well, don't you think?
I'll tell you to say so.
No need. She can hear it for herself. Can't you, darling? I trust you know my daughter, Kathy. Yes, my daughter. You're probably asking, why the nom de plume and why doesn't my daughter work for me? Good questions. I offered Kathy a life of wealth and leisure. Instead, she chose to pursue a career. And she was showing real promise until this recent lapse. But we're done with all that now, aren't we, sweetheart?
Chester,
don't trouble the boy with your problems, dearest. Mr. Kelly has a plate full of his own. Wouldn't you say so, Mr. Snyder?
Hello, Jack.
Does anyone else feel a noose tightening? But allow me to offer an alternate scenario. You attend this rally and speak against this hopeless strike, and I'll see your criminal records expunged and your pockets filled with enough cash to carry you in a first-class train compartment from New York to New Mexico and beyond. You did say you wanted to travel west, didn't you?
The person in this room will know you stink.
And if they know me, they know I don't care. Mark my words, boy. Defy me, and I will have you and every last one of your friends locked up in the refuge. I know you're Mr. Tough Guy, but it ain't right to condemn that little cripple boy to conditions like that. And what about your pal Davey and his loving little brother, ripped from their loving families and tossed to the wrecks? Will they ever be able to thank you enough?
You've been given discretion to deal with you as we see fit. Just the pain.
Brass knuckles!
Time's running out, kid. So what do you say? Cowboy or convict, I win either way. Your abject surrender was always the bottom line. Gentlemen, escort our guests to the cellar so he might reflect in solitude.
Sleep on that old printing press. That's for.
Job, Jack, but you did decline. Too bad you're the family, but you can't have mine. Be glad you're alive, boy, I'd say that's the bottom line.
Let
the black eye for you, let them play. Till those
kids
all believe you arrive. Don't be for
them. All of one got away. They may not be so lucky to die.
Thank you.
neighborhood here tonight. Tonight, you're making history.
Yeah!
Tonight, we declare that we're just as much a part of the newspaper as any reporter or editor.
Yeah!
We are done being treated like kids. From now on, they will treat us as equals.
Yeah!
Don't be treated like adults. Start acting like adults. Don't just run your mouth. Make some sense.
And here's Zach.
A little raise the price of paper, not so much as a word. That was a lousy thing to do. So we get mad, show them that we weren't going to be pushed around. So we go on strike, then what happens? Lowers the prices, so we go back to work. A few weeks later, he hikes them right back up again. And don't think he won't. What do we do next? What do we do if we decide to raise them again? Let's be realistic, fellas. How long can we go without making money? Believe me, Pulitzer can go longer. But I have spoken to Mr. Pulitzer. He has said that if we disband the union, he won't raise the prices for another 2 years. I say we go back to work knowing our prices are secure. All you have to do is vote no on the strike. Vote no! Myself, or is there something?
Of course there is.
Don't say it like it happens every day. I ain't stupid. Girls like you don't go for God like me. I don't want you promising nothing, you're just gonna have to take back later.
Jack.
Standing here, looking at you, makes me hope tomorrow won't come and change everything. There was a way that I could just hold on to something, like this, keep looking at you.
Snuck up on me, Jack,
honey.
For sure. The moment I found you, I thought I knew what a love was. Now I'm learning what is true, and follow through what it does. The world finds ways to sting you, and then one day it decides to bring you something to
that's a film. there's change coming once and for all. You makes the front page, and man, you is major news. Tomorrow they'll see what we are, and sure as a star, we ain't come this far.
You're behind this? We had a deal.
We came with a money back guarantee.
thanks for your advice on power of the papers.
See this, boss? This kid's been on a pretty good paper. It's very convincing.
No doubt, written by my doctor.
I've signed it, of course, with another statute.
I demand to know who defied my ban on printing strike material.
We're your loyal employees. We'd never take our business elsewhere.
I made you the offer of a lifetime. Anyone who does not act in his own self-interest is a fool.
Yeah, and what's that make you? This all started because you just wanted to sell more papers, but now your circulation's down 70%. Why didn't you just come talk to us?
Because Joe don't talk to nothing like us. But a very wise reporter once told me, a real boss don't need all that. Just the smarts that snatch the right one when he hears.
Now is the time to seize the day. Stare down the odds and seize the day. Minute by minute, that's how you win it. We will find a way. But let us seize the day.
Come look at that flip.
Now is the time to seize.
New York is closed for business. Paralyzed. You can't get the shoe shine. Hot dog, cross the Brooklyn Bridge, you can't even leave your own building. What's your next move, Joe?
Mr. Pulitzer, the mayor is here, and you're never going to believe who else.
Good morning, Mr. Pulitzer. I think you know the governor.
Governor Roosevelt?
Joseph. What have you done now?
Mr. Governor, I'm certain when you hear my explanation.
I already have a thorough grasp of the situation. Graphic illustration included. Bully is usually the expression I use to show approval, but in your case, I simply mean bully. And is this the boy from you spoke? No worries, I told you what to share to care, guys.
Pleasure's mine, Mr. Governor.
Well, Joe, don't just sit there letting these children sing endlessly. Give the good news.
What good news?
Should you come to your senses and roll back the prices? Unless you want to invite a full state Senate investigation into your employment practices.
You wouldn't.
After the pressure you feel to keep me from office? I do with a smile. Come along, Joseph. There's only one thing worse than a hard heart. Not to stop that. And just think of the happiness you bring all these children. He doesn't do happiness, does he?
Mr. Kelly, if I may speak to you alone.
Eyes on the stars and your feet on the ground. You can do this.
I cannot put the price back where it was. I'm sorry, I can't. There are other considerations.
I get it. You have to save the face for all these folks. I'm young, and I am stupid.
Thank you for understanding.
But I have constituents with legitimate gripe.
How about I reduce the raise by half and get the others to do the same? It's a compromise we all can live with.
Then you eat our losses. From now on, every paper we don't sell, you buy back full price.
That's never been on the table. What's to stop losers from buying hundreds of papers they can't sell? My costs will explode.
No loser's going to haul around papers that they can't sell. But if you give them a few extra, your circulation just might begin to improve. It's a compromise we all can do.
That's not a bad head you've got on your shoulder.
Do we have a deal?
That's disgusting!
Just the price of doing business.
Growing.
claim to our world, and I believe the future in your hands will be bright and prosperous. I've got another matter to bear. Officers, if you please.
Hey, Jack, look at this crunchy!
Thank you.
like to call all four of our directors to the stage, please. Ms. Tan, Mr.
by all of us, and we all love you to death, and we all thank you so much for what you've done.